In this video, we will cover the required maintenance to keep your fuse running smoothly and printing successfully. Lapses in maintenance to your fuse can result in print defects, print failures, device errors, and even damage to the fuse. For all maintenance procedures, Formlabs recommends wearing a KN95 mask or better, and wearing disposable gloves. To track the maintenance of your fuse, access the maintenance menu on the display screen. You will see a list of necessary maintenance tasks, each counting the number of printing hours before the task should be completed. As each counter approaches the maximum number of hours, it will turn yellow. If it passes the maximum, it will turn red. Selecting a task on the screen will bring up a step-by-step guide on how to complete the maintenance, as well as a QR code to a Formlabs article detailing the process. To reset the counter after performing the maintenance, touch the square next to the task name. At the bottom of the maintenance menu, you will find Motor Moves, a useful tool in your maintenance routines. This menu allows you to select and control the five motors of the fuse: the doser, the hopper flipper, the buffer flipper, the recoder roller, and the Z-drive. Moving these parts will allow you better access to hard-to-reach parts of the print area when cleaning, and are important in diagnosing mechanical printing issues. Please note, using motor moves can cause harm to the operator and the device if used improperly. Please ensure the printer is clear of obstructions, and do not reach inside the machine while motors are moving. Over time, powder can accumulate at the bottom of the print enclosure. Every 100 hours, remove the build chamber, disconnect the vacuum from the sift, and use it to vacuum up any powder found at the bottom of the print enclosure. Above the print area is the optical cassette, which protects the camera lenses and laser window from the buildup of laurolactam, a white powdery byproduct of the sintering process, and other airborne contaminants. Every 100 hours, remove the optical cassette and inspect the two glass windows for clouding, smudges, and contaminants such as powder particles or dust. The smaller window located at the front of the optical cassette protects the camera lens, and the larger window at the back protects the upper laser window. To clean the optical cassette windows, wet an optical cleaning cloth found in your maintenance materials box with denatured ethyl alcohol and wipe the surface of the glass. Do not dispense the ethyl alcohol directly onto the glass or touch the glass with anything but the optical cleaning cloth. If the optical cassette windows cannot be cleaned by the ethyl alcohol, you'll need to use Alkanox, a detergent you can purchase through a third-party seller. Alkanox comes in a powder form and will need to be mixed with water before it can be applied to the glass. In cases where Alkanox is required, follow the same procedure by applying it to an optical cleaning cloth and cleaning the glass, but follow this with wiping the glass with the distilled water, and then another cleaning with the ethyl alcohol. This ensures that all of the Alkanox is removed from the glass before the optical cassette is used in the fuse, as it will not evaporate from the glass like the ethyl alcohol will. Even with the optical cassette protecting them, the camera lens and upper laser windows will also need regular cleaning. Every 500 hours, remove the optical cassette and use the telescoping lighted mirror found in your maintenance supply box to locate the camera lens above the print area toward the front of the printer. Apply ethyl alcohol to an optical cleaning cloth and gently wipe the surface of the lens. Every 1,000 hours, use the mirror to locate the upper laser window located above the print area toward the back of the printer, higher up than the camera lens. Apply ethyl alcohol to an optical cleaning cloth and gently wipe the glass surface of the upper laser window. The fuse tracks the temperature of the print bed using an IR sensor. You can access the IR sensor by opening the hatch at the top of the fuse and pulling the sensor away from the magnets below it. The fuse will beep, acknowledging that the sensor has been removed. Every 100 hours, remove the IR sensor and inspect the mirrored glass at the bottom. If the lens appears cloudy or smudged, apply ethyl alcohol to an optical cleaning cloth and gently wipe the surface. When the sensor is clean, carefully replace the IR sensor inside the fuse. The magnets will pull the sensor down into the hole, and the fuse will beep to let you know that it's fully secured. Below the IR sensor is the IR sensor cone, which directs airflow away from the IR sensor and down into the print area. This airflow keeps the IR sensor clean from laurolactam and other contaminants, while allowing the sensor an unobstructed line of sight to the print bed. Laurolactam can build up at the top of this cone, reducing the effectiveness of the IR sensor, causing print defects and even failures. Every 100 hours, use the telescoping lighted mirror to inspect the IR sensor cone above the print area, between the camera lens and the upper laser window. To clean the IR sensor cone of any laurolactam that may be present, wet a clean room swab found in your maintenance material box with ethyl alcohol and reach up to brush at the sides of the IR sensor cone and the hole at the top. If you remove the swab and find that it is dirty after cleaning, wet another clean room swab with ethyl alcohol and repeat the cleaning. The IR sensor cone is clean when the clean room swab comes away completely clean. Located on the lower right side of the fuse is the filter cabinet. Inside this cabinet, towards the front, is the intake filter. This filter keeps airborne contaminants from entering the fuse air handling system. The filter towards the back of the cabinet is the exhaust filter, which keeps any powder or harmful gases from exiting the fuse. Both of these filters will become dirty over time and will need to be vacuumed off every 30 hours. Every 2,400 hours, the filters are no longer effective and will need to be replaced. At the very back of the filter cabinet is the exhaust line, a long tube from the back of the print enclosure to the filter cabinet. This tube can become clogged by laurolactam buildup over time and requires cleaning every 500 hours. Before cleaning the exhaust line, use the blue manual door release ring found just above the intake filter to open the door of the fuse. If the build chamber is inside the print enclosure, remove it from the printer. Please note that the door of the fuse needs to remain open during the cleaning process. If closed, the negative pressure from the vacuum will pull all of the powder from the hopper into your print area, causing a large amount of wasted powder and cleanup. Once the fuse door is open, place the end of the vacuum hose up to the bottom of the exhaust line opening. Using the long pipe brush found in your maintenance toolbox, insert it into the exhaust line and run it up and down the tube several times. White powdery laurolactam may become dislodged and fall from the exhaust line. The vacuum will catch it if it does. Once you have finished working with the long pipe brush, hold the opening of the vacuum to the opening of the exhaust line to purge any remaining loose laurolactam. Afterward, locate the other end of the exhaust line inside the printed closure, behind where the build chamber sits. Repeat the process of putting the vacuum up to this end of the exhaust line for 60 seconds in order to fully purge the tube of laurolactam. Lastly, if you suspect that your build chamber requires maintenance, please refer to our support articles for steps to complete these processes. Next up, we'll be going through the process of maintaining the sift.